Hi everyone, welcome back to KipDC Math. Today we will compare groups. So little baby Opal and little baby Bruno were in puppy school, and they were learning all the things that little puppies have to learn. During snack time, Opal opened up her bag of dog treats first. Look what she had. Then Bruno opened up his bag of dog treats, and look what he had. Now I'm wondering, who has more? That's right. Opal has more dog treats. We don't even have to count to know that Opal definitely has more. But let's count just to be sure. Count how many Opal has. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So Opal had 8 dog treats. Now let's count Bruno's. 1, 2, 3. And Bruno only had 3. So we know for sure that Opal has more because 8 is bigger than 3. But Opal and Bruno wanted to figure out exactly how many more Opal had than Bruno. And that's what it means to compare. When we compare, we find out exactly how much more or how much less one thing is than another. Let me show you how they figured out exactly how much more Opal had than Bruno. They decided to match up their dog treats. So Bruno put out his first dog treat and Opal put out her first one. They knew they both had 1. Then Bruno put out his second one and Opal put out her second one. And then they got to 3. And Bruno said, "I don't have any more. I only have 3." So Opal laid out all of her extras. And they realized that these ones were the dog treats where they both had the same amount. And so they just counted the ones where Opal had more or extra. So they counted this one and this one and this one and this one and this one. Those are all the dog treats that Opal has that Bruno doesn't have. Let's count how many more Opal has. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they knew that Opal had 5 more dog treats than Bruno. Did you see what they did there? They lined up the treats where they were the same. They knew that they both had 1, 2, 3 dog treats, and then they just counted the treats that were more or extra. That's one way you can compare to find how much more or less something is. Let's continue to explore how we can compare with Opal and Bruno. They were having so much fun comparing groups that during art time, they decided to compare how many crayons the two of them had. Opal opened up her crayon box and she had 6 crayons, like this. And then Bruno opened up his crayon box and he had 11 crayons, like this. So we know that Opal had 6 crayons and Bruno has 11 crayons. Who has more crayons? Does Opal have more crayons or does Bruno have more crayons? That's right. Bruno has more crayons. We know that because 11 is a bigger number than 6. So Bruno has more crayons than Opal. But Bruno and Opal wanted to figure out exactly how many more crayons Bruno had than Opal. And so just like they did with their treats, they matched each of their crayons up to find the part that was the same. So they knew they both had 1, they knew they both had 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. But then Bruno ran out of crayons to match up with Opal. Opal didn't have any more crayons, so Bruno knew that those extras, this one, and this one, and this one, and this one, and this one, those were the ones that he had that were more, or extra. So how many more crayons does Bruno have? That's right, he has 5 more crayons. He counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bruno has 5 more crayons than Opal has. Just like they did with their dog treats, they matched up the crayons that they had that were the same, And then they found the crayons that were more or extra, and they just counted those to figure out how many more Bruno had than Opal. Okay, friends, hooray for your super brain. Today we learned that we can compare groups. When we compare, we can find exactly how many more is in one group than another group.